whenever you have a conflict or an issue, first industries that really see considerable growth, agriculture, of course. You have industries like construction material. You have industries like hotels and properties. Those are the first industries that we see a lot of activities in FCS countries. Most of the countries, particularly in this region in sub-Saharan Africa, if you think about it, about 60% in some cases of the population is employed in agriculture or depends on agriculture. So really, if we have anything to do, it's about agriculture. If we want to alleviate poverty, it has to be around agriculture. So what do? The first thing is create the right climate. You cannot do agriculture if the investment climate remains the same. So we need to unleash the investment climate. And this is where the World Bank Group can add a lot of value. By that I mean, you know, allowing the importation of agri-inputs, for example, or sustaining or creating the agri-supply chains and so on. The investment case of FCS in agriculture, I think you have to be more specific around working with farmers and how you integrate farmers into markets. That's, I think, an answer that we try to do in everything we do in FCS, is how do we increase that linkage between farmers and markets. The biggest challenge is really to work with small entrepreneurs that may not have the right capital structure of the capital to actually implement expansion projects. So you can imagine if you're working with a cement company in a country like Liberia, you know, cement is crucial for an FCS because it would help on the development of infrastructure projects, development of housing, and so on. So this is one of the first sectors we see. But if you're going to work with a company that may not have the right capital structure, using blended finance tools would allow us to actually invest in these companies. FCS, if we want to, as an IFC, really respond to the need, the status quo is not going to help us. So we need to think differently about how to create, how to promote businesses in FCS. So I said, you need to create a climate. That's crucial. But you can really move the investment operations in two ways. So you can bring the SME ventures or any venture capital type activity to actually provide seed capital to entrepreneurs. So that's crucial. And today, I understand we are in the process of developing a number of new initiatives around that area to promote the creation of venture capital funds or to grow venture capital funds in FCS countries. I mean, this is crucial. The second point is intermediation. We need to get banks to lend. And to get banks to lend, obviously the banks have to be strong. They need to have the right risk systems in process so they'd be able to assess risk and to lend. And they need to have the right capital, of course. So IFC can provide not only the capital, but also can provide the advisory capacity to banks. And the last one is one of the things I've always think about FCS and generally in very poor countries, is IFC as a business creator. So we need to start focusing on creating businesses as opposed to supporting businesses. It's a very different mentality to say, you know, I'm going to help you, farmer, as opposed to let's work together and create a business, farmer. It's a different mentality, but I think it's required, especially in Africa. It's like an expedition. Somebody has to go ahead. It's like the Marines, you know, you have to go ahead and clear the beach. CASA is that. To have CASA and really operate in many difficult environments, and to have people there to actually start understanding who's who, to start helping us, assessing markets, assessing basically government regulations, it creates to us the right entry point. Without CASA, we couldn't work in many FCS countries. Without CASA, we couldn't do what we're doing in DRC or Liberia or in Sierra Leone and all these countries. Without CASA, we just couldn't do it. I would say what we need to do is to take CASA perhaps a bit more seriously internally within the IFC and really put the efforts and resources that CASA really needs. One easy thing is for senior management to look at, you know, CASA differently and say, look, this is our FCS entry point. This is our Marines, you know. So That's CASA for me, and I think, and don't confuse it. Don't get anybody else to get into what CASA does, I think. So that to me is what I think needs to improve. Generally, I think we do an okay job, I would say, working with donors. So I think that if we are clear as an IFC of the role of CASA, I think donors, there are more people to work with around the donor community. So I think once IFC takes a decision that CASA is our vehicle for FCS, no questions asked, right? It's all clear. You will see additional attention from donors to come into supporting CASA. The second thing is I mentioned what sort of investments does FCS need and what sort of capital. And risk capital a la mode of venture capital is what is required. So that's also a partnership. We don't work with a lot of venture capital firms. And of course, many may not be looking at Africa as a market, but again, if no one goes and looks for them to come, nothing will happen. So that marriage has to, I would say CASA could play a role of bringing more venture capital firms to look at some of these countries. So I would say that to be two key relationships that I would work on. Get out of the comfort zone of a traditional due diligence, which is you go see the firm, you talk to the management, and go see, just go follow the supply, talk to labor, talk to the farmers, talk to distributors, and you will understand the impact of a dollar of IFC in a country.